This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. The first Czechoslovak Republic, Czech, Slovak, Československá republika, was the Czechoslovak state that existed from 1918 to 1938. The state was commonly called Czechoslovakia Československo. It was composed of Bohemia, Moravia, Czech Silesia, Slovakia and Subcarpathian Ruthenia. After 1933, Czechoslovakia remained the only functioning democracy in Central and Eastern Europe under pressure from its Sudeten German minority, supported by neighboring Nazi Germany. Czechoslovakia was forced to cede its Sudetenland region to Germany on 1 October 1938 as part of the Munich Agreement. It also ceded southern parts of Slovakia and Subcarpathian Ruthenia to Hungary and the Zalzy region in Silesia to Poland. This, in effect, ended the First Czechoslovak Republic. It was replaced by Second Czechoslovak Republic, which lasted less than half a year before Germany occupied the rest of Czechoslovakia. Contents: 1. History. 2. Politics. 21. Foreign policy. 3. Economy. 4. Ethnic groups. 5. Administrative divisions. 6. See also. 7. References. 8. Bibliography. History. Main article: History of Czechoslovakia 1918-1938. The interwar Czechoslovakia. The independence of Czechoslovakia was proclaimed on October 28, 1918, by the Czechoslovak National Council in Prague. Several ethnic groups and territories with different historical, political, and economic traditions had to be blended into a new state structure. The origin of the First Republic lies in point 10 of Woodrow Wilson's 14 points. The people's of Austria-Hungary, whose place among the nations we wish to see safeguarded and assured, should be accorded the freest opportunity to autonomous development. The full boundaries of the country and the organization of its government was finally established in the Czechoslovak Constitution of 1920. Tomáš Garrigue Masaryk had been recognized by World War I allies as the leader of the Provisional Czechoslovak Government, and in 1920 he was elected the country's first president. He was re-elected in 1925 and 1929, serving as president until December 14, 1935, when he resigned due to poor health. He was succeeded by Edvard Beneš. Following the Anschluss of Nazi Germany and Austria in March 1938, Nazi leader Adolf Hitler's next target for annexation was Czechoslovakia. His pretext was the privations suffered by ethnic German populations living in Czechoslovakia's northern and western border regions, known collectively as the Sudetenland. Their incorporation into Nazi Germany would leave the rest of Czechoslovakia powerless to resist subsequent occupation politics. To a large extent, Czechoslovak democracy was held together by the country's first president, Tomáš Masaryk, as the principal founding father of the republic. Masaryk was regarded similar to the way George Washington is regarded in the United States. Such universal respect enabled Masaryk to overcome seemingly irresolvable political problems. Masaryk is still regarded as the symbol of Czechoslovak democracy. The Constitution of 1920 approved the Provisional Constitution of 1918. In its basic features, the Czechoslovak state was conceived as a parliamentary democracy, guided primarily by the National Assembly, consisting of the Senate and the Chamber of Deputies, whose members were to be elected on the basis of universal suffrage. The National Assembly was responsible for legislative initiative and was given supervisory control over the executive and judiciary as well. Every 7 years it elected the president and confirmed the cabinet appointed by him. Executive power was to be shared by the president and the cabinet, the latter, responsible to the National Assembly, was to prevail. The reality differed somewhat from this ideal, however. During the strong presidencies of Masaryk and his successor, Beneš, the Constitution of 1920 provided for the central government to have a high degree of control over local government. From 1928 and 1940, Czechoslovakia was divided into the four lands: Czech, Zem, Slovak, Krajina, Bohemia, Moravia, Silesia, Slovakia, and Carpathian Ruthenia. Although in 1927 assemblies were provided for Bohemia, Slovakia, and Ruthenia, their jurisdiction was limited to adjusting laws and regulations of the central government to local needs. The central government appointed one-third of the members of these assemblies. The constitution identified the Czechoslovak nation as the creator and principal constituent of the Czechoslovak state and established Czech and Slovak as official languages. The concept of the Czechoslovak nation was necessary in order to justify the establishment of Czechoslovakia towards the world, because otherwise the statistical majority majority of the Czechs as compared to Germans would have been rather weak, and there would have been more Germans in the state than Slovaks. National minorities were assured special protection, in districts where they constituted 20% of the population. Members of minority groups were granted full freedom to use their language in everyday life, in schools, and in matters dealing with authorities. Tomáš Garrigue Masaryk, the founding father and first president of the Czechoslovak Republic. The operation of the new Czechoslovak government was distinguished by stability largely. Responsible for this were the well-organized political parties that emerged as the real centers of power, excluding the period from March 1926 to November 1929, when the coalition did not hold. A coalition of five Czechoslovak parties constituted the backbone of the government: Republican Party of Agricultural and Smallholder People, Czechoslovak Social Democratic Party, Czechoslovak National Socialist Party, Czechoslovak People's Party, and Czechoslovak National Democratic Party. The leaders of these parties became known as the Pecka Pran Pietka. The five. The Pecka was headed by Antonín Svila, who held the office of prime minister for most of the 1920s and designed a pattern of coalition politics that survived until 1938. The coalition's policy was expressed in the slogan "We have agreed that we will agree." German parties also participated in the government in the beginning of 1926. Hungarian parties, influenced by irredentist propaganda from Hungary, never joined the Czechoslovak government but were not openly hostile. The Republican Party of Agricultural and Smallholder People was formed in 1922 from a merger of the Czech Agrarian Party and the Slovak Agrarian Party led by Svila. The new party became the principal voice for the agrarian population, representing mainly peasants with small and medium-sized farms. Svila combined support for progressive social legislation with a democratic outlook. His party was the core of all government coalitions between 1922 and 1938. The Czechoslovak Social Democratic Party was considerably weakened when the communists seceded in 1921 to form the Communist Party of Czechoslovakia, but by 1929 it had begun to regain its strength, a party of moderation. The Czechoslovak Social Democratic Party declared in favor of parliamentary democracy in 1930. Antonín Hampel was chairman of the party, and Ivan Dérár was the leader of its Slovak branch. The Czechoslovak National Socialist Party, called the Czech Socialist Party until 1926, was created before World War I. When the Socialists split from the Social Democratic Party, it rejected class struggle and promoted nationalism led by Václav Klofák. Its membership derived primarily from the lower middle class, civil servants, and the intelligentsia, including Beneš, the Czechoslovak People's Party. The Czechoslovak National Democratic Party became the party of big business, banking, and industry. The party declined in influence after 1920. However, foreign policy. Edvard Beneš, Czechoslovak foreign minister from 1918 to 1935, created the system of alliances that determined the republic's international stance until 1938. A democratic statesman of Western orientation, Beneš relied heavily on the League of Nations as guarantor of the post-war status quo and the security of newly formed states. He negotiated the Little Entente, an alliance with Yugoslavia and Romania in 1921 to counter Hungarian revanchism and Habsburg restoration. He attempted further to negotiate treaties with Britain and France, seeking their promises of assistance in the event of aggression against the small, democratic Czechoslovak Republic. Britain remained intransigent in its isolationist policy and, in 1924, Beneš concluded a separate alliance with France. Beneš's Western policy received a serious blow as early as 1925. The Locarno Pact, which paved the way for Germany's admission to the League of Nations, guaranteed Germany's western border. French troops were thus left immobilized on the Rhine, making French assistance to Czechoslovakia difficult. In addition, the treaty stipulated that Germany's eastern frontier would remain subject to negotiation. When Adolf Hitler came to power in 1933, fear of German aggression became widespread in eastern Central Europe. Beneš ignored the possibility of a stronger Central European alliance system, remaining faithful to his Western policy. He did, however, seek the participation of the Soviet Union in an alliance to include France. Beneš's earlier attitude towards the Soviet regime had been one of caution. In 1935, the Soviet Union signed treaties with France and Czechoslovakia. In essence, the treaties provided that the Soviet Union would come to Czechoslovakia's aid only if French assistance came first. In 1935, when Beneš succeeded Masaryk as president, the Prime Minister Milan Hoxha took over the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. Hoxha Bruges' efforts to strengthen alliances in Central Europe came too late in February 1936. The foreign ministry came under the direction of Camille Crofta, an adherent of Benes's line economy. The new nation had a population of over 135 million. It had inherited 70 to 80% of all the industry of the Austro-Hungarian Empire, including the porcelain and glass industries and the sugar refineries, more than 40% of all its distilleries and breweries, the Škoda Works of Pilsen-Plzeň, which produced armaments, locomotives, automobiles, and machinery, and the chemical industry of northern Bohemia, 17% of all Hungarian industry that had developed in Slovakia during the late 19th century also fell to the Republic. Czechoslovakia was one of the world's 10 most industrialized states. Czechoslovakia 1920-1938. The Czech lands were far more industrialized than Slovakia in Bohemia, Moravia, and Silesia. 39% of the population was employed in industry and 31% in agriculture and forestry. Most light and heavy industry was located in the Sudetenland and was owned by Germans and controlled by German-owned banks. Czechs controlled only 20-30% of all industry. Citation needed. In Slovakia, 171% of the population was employed in industry, and 604% worked in agriculture and forestry. Only 5% of all industry in Slovakia was in Slovak hands. Carpathian Ruthenia was essentially without industry in the agricultural sector. A program of reform introduced soon after the establishment of the Republic was intended to rectify the unequal distribution of land. One-third of all agricultural land and forests belonged to a few aristocratic landowners, mostly Germans or Germanized Czechs, e.g. Kinsky, Chernin or Konitz, and Hungarians, and the Roman Catholic Church. Half of all holdings were under 20,000 square meters. The Land Control Act of April 1919 called for the expropriation of all estates exceeding 15 square kilometers of arable land or 25 square kilometers of land in general. 5 square kilometers to be the absolute maximum. Redistribution was to proceed on a gradual basis. Owners would continue in possession in the interim, and compensation was offered. Ethnic groups 1921 ethnonational census. Regions: Czechoslovaks, Czechs and Slovaks, Germans, Hungarians, Rusyns, Jews, others. Total Bohemia 4 388 2 788 2 173 239 5 476 2 007 11 251 93 757 6 668 518. Moravia 2048 426 547 604 534 976 15 335 46 448 2 649 323. Silesia 296 194 252 365 94 338 3 681 49 530 602 202. Slovakia 2,013,792,139,900 637 183 85 644 70 529 42 313 2 989 361. Carpathian Ruthenia 19 737 10 460 102 144 372 884 80 059 6 760 592 044. Czechoslovak Republic 8 760 937 3 123 568 745 431 461 849 188 55 238 080 13 410 750. National disputes arose due to the fact that the more numerous Czechs dominated the central government and other national institutions, all of which had their seats in the Bohemian capital Prague. The Slovak middle class had been extremely small in 1919 because Hungarians, Germans and Jews had previously filled most administrative, professional and commercial positions in, and as a result, the Czechs had to be posted to the more backward Slovakia to take up the administrative and professional posts. The position of the Jewish community, especially in Slovakia, was ambiguous and, increasingly, a significant part looked towards Zionism. Furthermore, most of Czechoslovakia's industry was as well located in Bohemia and Moravia, while most of Slovakia's economy came from agriculture in Carpatho-Ukraine. The situation was even worse, with basically no industry at all due to Czechoslovakia's centralized political structure. Nationalism arose in the non-Czech nationality, and several parties and movements were formed with the aim of broader political autonomy, like the Sudeten German Party led by Konrad Henlein and the Hlinka's Slovak People's Party led by Andrei Hlinka. The German minority living in Sudetenland demanded autonomy from the Czech government, claiming they were suppressed and repressed in the 1935 parliamentary elections. The newly founded Sudeten German Party, led by Konrad Henlein and mostly financed by Nazi German money, received over two-thirds of the Sudeten German vote as a consequence. Diplomatic relations between the Germans and the Czechs deteriorated further. Administrative divisions 1918-1923, different systems in former Austrian territory Bohemia, Moravia, a small part of Silesia compared to former Hungarian territory Slovakia and Ruthenia, three lands Zeme also called district units Krahe, Bohemia, Moravia, Silesia, plus 21 counties Zuppi in today's Slovakia and three counties in today's Ruthenia. Both lands and counties were divided into districts Okresy 1923-1927, as above, except that the Slovak and Ruthenian counties were replaced by six grand counties Velzipi in Slovakia and one grand county in Ruthenia, and the numbers and boundaries of the okresy were changed in those two territories 1928-1938, four lands Czech, Zeme, Slovak, Krajina, Bohemia, Moravia Silesia, Slovakia and Subcarpathian Ruthenia, divided into districts okresy see also Germans in Czechoslovakia 1918-1938. Hungarians in Slovakia, Polish minority in the Czech Republic, Ruthenians and Ukrainians in Czechoslovakia 1918-1938, Slovaks in Czechoslovakia 1918-38, Jews in Slovakia. References: Carrot, Spencer Tucker, Priscilla Mary Roberts, 2005, World War II, A Political, Social, and Military History, ABC Clio, ISBN. Wikimedia Commons has media related to Czechoslovak Republic 1918-1938. Karnik, Zdeněk, Malé dějiny Československé 1867-1939, Dokoran 2008, Praha, ISBN 978-80-7363-146-8. Czech Olivova, Vera, Dějiny Privatní Republiky, Karolinum Press 2000, Praha, ISBN 80-7184-791-7. Czech Perutka, Ferdinand, Budova Statu IIV, Academia 2003, Praha, ISBN 80-200-1121-8. Czech Jen František Moravec, Spion Jemuz Nevrili, ISBN 80-200-1006-8. Czech Axworthy, Mark Wa, Axis Slovakia, Hitler's Slavic Wedge, 1938-1945, Bayside, NY 1948-1989-1989-1992-1993, Bohemia Moravia Silesia Austrian Empire First Republika Sudetenland B Third Republic Czechoslovak Republic 1948-1960 Czechoslovak Socialist Republic 1960-1990 Czech and Slovak Federative Republic 1990-1992 Czech Republic Second 1991 Present Austria-Hungary Czechoslovak Government in Exile A CSR, Boundaries and Government Established by the 1920 Constitution B Annexed by Nazi Germany C CSR, Included the Autonomous Regions of Slovakia and Carpathian Ruthenia D Annexed by Hungary 1939-1945 E CSR, Declared a People's Democracy without formal name change under the 9th of May Constitution following the 1948 coup F CSSR, from 1969 after the Prague Spring, consisted of the Czech Socialist Republic CSR and Slovak Socialist Republic SSR G Oblast of the Ukrainian SSR H Oblast of Ukraine.